Okay, one thing I want to talk about at least a little bit here, since we have our navigation set up and things like that, one thing we should mention is some optimization. So, depending on your video card and your computer setup, this may be a very big deal for you right now, or maybe a small deal. One thing we can do is just look at the frames. So, if we go here and say stats, not stats, show FPS is what we want. Frames per second. And you can see I'm way up high in the hundreds here, and that is great. That is easy. That's good. Everything's great. So you may not have to do any optimization if you're running at the same kind of speeds I am. With VR, you need 90 frames per second. With first person navigation, it's more like 30 frames per second, and you'll be fine. Okay, so as long as it's in the green up here, you'll be good to go. Okay, but if you are having problems with frame rate, then you will need to know some optimization stuff. So we've looked at some things previously in the course in earlier sections, and you guys know that some things are being done in screen space, meaning they happen and are being calculated in real time, and other things are burnt in. So turning off screen space things will speed up your time. Turning off the post-process actor, because that's all happening at real time. So, in a post-process actor, you can go down to the right here, post-process volume settings enabled. We can just turn it off. This gives us a very different look, obviously, but that will speed up frame time for you. Okay, I'm going to leave mine on because it's working just fine. Okay, and other screen space things, like you can go to show lighting features and you can turn off things like screen space ambient occlusion, screen space contact shadows, screen space reflections. Okay, those things can all help you, but they also cost you, the quality of your image. So you'll have to balance that. Another thing that we can do, I've talked about overdraw. Some of that is if we go to optimization view modes and go to overdraw and shader, well, let's go to shader complexity. Okay, so you'll see anything where I have opacity and things behind opacity and, looking through glass. All those things are going to be complicated and they're in the red and white, which is extremely bad according to this. But, what else are you going to do if you need to have glass in your scene? And in architecture, this is going to be a common problem. So there is ways to fix the foliage to be better. This bamboo is not optimized as well as these trees are, and that's because of the way the polygons are formed, as we discussed earlier. There's too much excess space around the opacity map, so there's a ton of transparency over transparency over transparency, and that's what's making this so difficult. Okay, so that could be optimized better. But ultimately, we're going to have to find other ways to optimize because we need glass and we need transparency. So let's talk about one other way where we can do optimizations, and that is with levels of detail. So let's use this chair as an example. If we click on the mesh of this chair, let's look at it and let's put it in wireframe. So it's pretty heavy wireframe-wise, especially down here where these wrinkles are. Okay, so what we can do is generate levels of detail and make it so that as we move further away from the chair, it is going to become optimized and have way less polygons. Now, Unreal Engine can do this for us automatically, which is quite awesome. It is very similar to the Pro Optimize tool if you're used to using that in 3D Studio Max. It can do that for you, and you can set the distance, basically, how far you want to be away before it optimizes. So, right now, as an example, let's look at this chair. It has On import, it has just one level of detail. We can set it to two or three or whatever we want, but two will suffice in this case. And then we apply changes. Now, in the LOD picker, we can go to LOD1. We can go to LOD1, and now we can adjust LOD1 for what we want. Okay, so we can go into LOD1 here and say reduction settings. Right now it's at 100%, so it's not actually reducing at all. For demonstration purposes, let's go all the way down to 10% and then apply changes. Like Pro Optimizer, it might take a second. Okay, there it is. And here you can see we're in LOD1, we're looking at LOD1. If you look at LOD0, it's the high res. If you put it on auto, then we'll see it change as we move away from the object, which is what is going to be happening in game. So that's a good way to look at it. If you look in wireframe, you'll see it looks like this, or out of wireframe, sorry, shaded mode. And as you move away, we know in wireframe that it is changing to low res, but you'll notice that it looks pretty much exactly the same, right? There just isn't a lot of change going on. So this can save us time and optimization with our models if we have some high res stuff in there. If we start running into problems with frame rate, we can do this. Now, the only other thing to mention here is how to adjust the distance at which it will change. And that would be if we go to LOD1, we can say, okay, down here in LOD settings, we can take auto compute LOD distance and turn it off. And now we can say what distance we want it to change at, basically. So if we go to this and go to wireframe again, right now it's changing right there. And that's being controlled by the screen size in LOD1. Okay, screen size 0.5. If we set that to like 0.9, then it'll change even sooner, because it's like when it's 90% of its normal size, it's going to change to the low res thing. Okay, so LOD auto, just like right there, it's now changing. So we could change that to be like 0.1. Then it really has to get small before it will actually change. Put this on auto now. And now you can see it's staying high res, staying high res, staying high res, staying high res. Right there is where it changes, right there, okay? So not until this thing gets really small in screen will it actually change. And that's adjusted by that screen size setting right here. I think if we set it to like 0.4, we'll be good. Okay, we can save that. And then look at it in game. So when we play, let's play in wireframe mode. Actually, not play, but... So here it's high res. And right there it changes. Okay, so as you get further away, it changes optimized for you. And since this static mesh and that static mesh are the same, that one should do it too, and it does. Okay, so the nice thing is that it pretty much looks the same, whether you're here or back here, and it changes basically effortlessly. You can see the light map changes a little bit on it, so you might want to adjust so that that doesn't happen until a little bit later. But you can see from this that you're really not going to notice, especially when you're out here. You just don't need that to be as high res anymore. So that can save you some time and optimize some things for you. That's how LODs work.